place that we meet. It's about that we gather in His name. Paul says, two or three gather in His name, He will be in the midst. And I'm going to talk a little bit about that in a few minutes, about how Jesus improvised. And he never caught him off guard when things happen in life that bring change. I don't know how you feel about it. We like change. I kind of like things to go like it always goes. But Jesus taught us in the Bible that when things happen, not to be taken back, not to let those things dictate your attitude or our thoughts, but to let invite the Lord, whatever circumstance you have today, and I believe, and you're believing, that God's going to do something amazing today. Amen?
Amen.
Just want to make one quick announcement before we pray, and we have a sign sheet for calling posts. What is the calling post? It's a call that I can do one call, and that's all. That's not a lawyer pitch, but commercial. I can make one call, and we can have, like, you sign up for the call post. If you like to be a part of that, sign up. I can call you, and it'll be an automated thing, and I can make one recording. It will go out in like 5 minutes to everybody in the church. How will this benefit us? When there's urgent prayer requests, one of our churchmen, one of our church families is urgent, we can get there and have the whole church within 5 minutes pray and intercede with them. Today, we could have said a call post if we had to say, guys, we're not in the sanctuary this morning, we're in the fellowship hall. So we have announcements that are coming. We got an upcoming event, very important, coming up called Vacation Bible School. And I'll have the Sister Kim's going to come up and announce that. Also, this call post, if you like, you don't have to be on there, put your number on there. I'll put you in the list, and we can send you either a recording, voice recording, a text, or an email, or more likely goes to the voice recording. So you'll hear from me and say, hey, there's Pastor Kenny on the call post again. If you'd like to be a part of that, please sign up. We'll start that this week. And our first kids come in today and say, "Why is a boat?" God's word. says, he got into the boat. He didn't fall into the boat. He got into the boat. He sat down in there, and he began to teach the multitude the Word of God. Think of this. The Word of God's going to work. And he didn't have all the fashion of the sound booth or sound. Of course, there are sound people and our media people. They do a great job week in, week out. He didn't have a luxury of a nice sanctuary. He definitely didn't have the luxury of having air conditioning. Come on, somebody. But Jesus used what was available. Remember that thought. Jesus used what was available. What did he do? He turned a boat into a pulpit.
Yeah.
He turned the lake into a sound system.
Yeah.
Ever been to a lake when you're in a lake and it has an echo or a project? Jesus, being the creator of all, he said, Peter, put me in a boat, push it out to the in the water. And Jesus that made the water, he was there. Anything that was made, that was ever made, was made by him. Salvation is coming to your house. Bible still open, turn to the verse 4 of Luke 5. When Jesus had stopped speaking, he said to Simon, "Launch out into the deep and let down your net." Launch into the deep and let down your net or catch. See what Jesus did? He shifted from there. Turned around and he saw both. faithful. Peter says this right here. After this happened, the word went forth. He preached the word. Bible is the life. some partnership and